and welcome to Blackout Gaming TV. My name is Samsky, and today I am joined with Hildreth as we see the first of the preseason playoffs for Premiership Highlander Season 10. It is Ragnaraka versus Nunya. Hildreth, how are you doing today?
Good, man. We've not got much time because the teams have actually just readied up. But from what I can tell you, Ragnarok, I think it's something to do with Norse mythology, Google tells me. Do you want to talk more about the teams though? Because Ragnarok are quite a familiar team with some people.
Yeah, I think they're mostly made up of a collection of old/new chess players that have collapsed and died and rebuilt, and now it's made of all Nordic players. So you have Lazy Bear on the medic, Onkar on the soldier, Kazul on the spy, Ali on demo, Kali on NG, that's going to get annoying, Mist on Sniper, Surfs on Scout, Husky on Heavy, and Scissors on Pyro, as we do go live.
Yeah, and their opponents, Nunya, is kind of the experiment rebirth with Joe and Layla. And they've obviously rebuilt their team again, but they're going to be on defense to begin with, and just to begin, we're going to have a suicide wave, not really synced up at all. So, well dealt with by Nunya. This roster, now I know you were saying before the game, Samsky, that you expected the Raggers, I'm going to call them the Raggers, to win this. But I think Nunya have a good shout tonight. There's another jump in by Ali again. And it's been pretty good so far for Nunya, a good solid start to the game.
I did say that I think they should win. Probably because, individually, they are more experienced players. However, as a team, they have not been scrimming nearly half as much as this Nunya roster. They have been scrimming like crazy. And this Ragnaroka team have only just formed in the last few days. I think you're absolutely right. Nunya have a huge chance, actually, to take this. And they're looking extremely strong at the moment. Aferix just going down after a nice 4K to open the show. And still looking very strong. The medic is coming out in the form of Lazy Bear right now. And they're looking to get this aggressive Uber Husky, putting a lot of damage onto the enemy combo. And the sentry is down to half HP. But Coletso just got a triple backstab and then a headshot, as you do, dropping the medic. But Nunya are actually going to get out after that, Kazul getting on the sentry. But wow, Coletso, what a play there.
Yeah, I'm quite surprised that Nunya are happy to give up their ground because they won that fight convincingly. They lost one player in the fight, two players if you include Coletso. Yeah, they've given up, they gave up the point and they're going to give Ragnaroka a chance to push in and push ground that they didn't actually earn, in my opinion, which I don't agree with, but they must fancy their hold in the tunnel. Yeah, they've already moved people into the tunnel. Joe might actually get caught out by this heavy. No, he manages to survive, and they've got a few picks. But the cart is moving, that's the key thing. This is kind of the old chess style, If you're going to give us ground, we're going to take it, we don't care. And I kind of disagree with that from Nunya.
Yeah, I'm going to call them the Raggers. I agree with you. I'm not going to pronounce Ragnaroka or whatever. And the Uber actually did get forced by the experiment now known as Nunya. But it has been soloed onto Husky, therefore it's going to be a better Uber. He's just going to get control of that tunnel and the headshot is going to ring out onto a Bacon and therefore go down. They're going to lose that heavy, and Layla is standing actually in the middle. I don't agree with this. She needs to get back. The sniper headshot's ringing out from Mist. As we do see a more passive hold onto this second, as Husky is about to peek down as heavy.
Yeah, they're kind of getting punished here. Oh, there's a soldier going in for the medic. Yeah, he's been dealt with by Husky. Good defensive work. But they've been punished for giving up that ground for free after convincingly winning a fight. That's something. That's a bit of a bad tactical choice. Now they've lost their key man, Joe. And they've managed to deal with the sniper threat on the right. And yeah, tactically, bad decision by Nunya. On that first point, and they've given the momentum to the Ragnarok. Can somebody in Twitch chat just, phonetically spell the team name for me? I'd really appreciate it, and I'll learn.
I'm guessing that, you know, that was what I was talking about, the Ragnarok or Raggers, whatever we're going to call them. Their team has more experience, and, you know, you saw that experience coming through. Nunya gave up all of that space, and they were like, hey, guys, if you're going to give up this space for free, then we're going to take it. As the Uber does come out from Lazy Bear, Counter Uber is going to be popped onto Tea Time, and he's going to try and blow the medic all the way, but Lazy Bear somehow survives by standing onto the house. He's going to escape underneath, and really well played there from Lazy Bear to survive that. Bacon is going to be pushing forward aggressively as the Heavy, and Jake and Jackie Legs is going to pop off that conch, and the picks are going in the way of Nunya for now, and the medic is going to do well to survive underneath with 30 HP. Actually saying that, Lazy Bear and Onkai just get picked off by Jackie Legs. Nice 3k there. So really well played there.
Yeah, I can guarantee they're not going to give up this point for free after getting their mid frag there. They're going to be very confident with their third point hold. Winning that fight is quite a good marker for them, because the Uber didn't really get anything done. They kind of just wandered in unsupported into a pyro, and they couldn't get the players without heals into the fight. They were blocked off by the defensive Uber. It's a good play now, but you know, it is an experienced team with a lot of ex-chess players, a lot of ex-champions that should be able to push up, take ground if they're offered it. At the moment they're kind of stuck though, so I think they're going to put people in the car, which is a good call.
Okay, someone in chat said that it's pronounced Ragnarok. So we were basically right, but I think it's like there's more length to the word, I guess. I'm going to call them the Raggers, I don't care. Like, it's much easier for me, and I don't want to sound like an idiot when I'm trying to pronounce some Norse word.
I've accepted that I'm going to sound like an idiot, so I'm just going to get on with it.
We are going to see Yumpu actually being really aggressive on trying to get onto Ali with that conch help from Jackie Legs. At the moment, nothing really happening. Scissor's actually doing quite well of pushing the cart here, just denying any spam that's going to be coming onto the cart. Saying that, Joe is going to get the spam onto Scissor. Scissor's going to pull out, and the cart is going to be staying on that lower platform for now.
Scissors. Okay, the pyro's challenging now, but he's unchallenged on that cart for a long time. That's probably that's a weakness to this defense. And now Joe's dropped back, and they're kind of taking this ground, and they've forced the Uber first as well, so Lazy Bear can kite this, and they can get an Uber advantage, and they've got the cart moving, so then you need to spread out, they put a defense on somewhere, either defend the choke point or defend the cart.
Yeah, Callie using the short circuit there really well, just denying any projectiles that were coming his way onto the cart. And now Kazul's going to sap that sentry. It's going to be dealt with, and wasn't synced up with the combo, yeah. And Lazy Bear is sitting at that 100% Uber right about now. So Husky's actually going to get dropped from this Uber, that it looks like they're going to solo it onto Ali, going to try and do as much damage as possible. Tea Time goes down, they need to focus down this sentry. Sentry's going to get dragged back, really well played there from Corndog, and I think they're just going to get back, because all gets picked off. But this looks like the car is going to get pushed through to third. Yep, the level 3 sentry is going to be put up for 4th, and you know, this is actually looking like a solid fullback, and they've got control off top, they've got that level 3 up.
Yeah, there's pressure on Kaya, almost got onto Layla there in the top. They've lost Joe in the front though, so they've good kills by Husky to spot that, and now they're holding on to an Uber, they can just try and force this Ragnarok. What I want to see from Nunya is to see if they can use this Uber effectively. They've had very good transitions so far.
Yeah, this is really well played at the moment. So the Uber does actually get forced out from Nunya, and Lazy Bear once again is sitting with a massive advantage. I don't know how that Uber did get forced out. Onkai just get picked off from a nice backstab from Colosso, and he's going to just be a pain in their backside at the moment. He's just going to, you know, try and annoy them, try and delay that Uber as much as possible. The Uber is looking like it's going to come front stairs. I think so. It looks like Husky's about to go up top. But Joe is sitting up the trap. I think it was Husky just going with the Fist of Steel to inspect where they're going to go. But Colosso actually gets picked off just before he's going to get onto the medic, and they're going to be pushing underneath. Joe is well aware of this though, and he's going to get a nice early force there, and they're going to back off, and Tea Time's actually doing a great job here of completely denying this Uber. He eventually goes down, and this is actually really good from the Raggers at the moment. They've got a lot of fight dominance. The only saving grace is that Bacon is putting a lot of damage through. He manages to pick off Scissors, and Kazul goes down underneath to Jackie Legs. Onkaya is spamming that sentry at the moment, and the frags are going left and right at the moment. Both teams are very weak players. Colosso goes down, and Nunya, they pop their Uber. They really need to get onto the medic though, and the medic is nowhere to be seen. Scissors is doing a really good job of denying Jackie Legs from pushing underneath, and actually Layla's going to go down to a nice sticky trap there from Ali.
That's such a interesting fight engagement. It's not over yet. Ali gets separated from his medic. I'd love to talk about that. Oh, Lazy Bear gets sniped, so now there's going to have the engineer on the cart. No one can deny him. Somebody at the Sentry does it in the end. It's getting a bit close here. Those Uber exchanges were so interesting.
Colossal going huge, manages to get the 2k on the cart. Sorry for interrupting you there, they're about to cap that off, and Colossal manages to pick it off. But he does go down now.
They're just going to regroup at the front here, but now they've got to be careful. Joe's actually been picked again. They're sort of in the last line of defence at the moment, Ninja. But they've done really good, like, buying time on every point, so whatever happens, it's going to be a decent time for them. It's a bit of a scattered fight at the moment.
Ninja's a bit lost at the moment as well. She's got no one to heal. She's sitting at 48%, and she's actually losing all of that Uber advantage that she had when Laserbear went down. She hasn't been healing for a large amount of time. I think that's one of the problems as later as a medic, is that when she loses Joe, her demo, or the heavy, she seems a bit lost. She doesn't know really where to position herself. They are going to link up now, but Lazy Bear is sitting at that Uber advantage. I don't know if they know about this. And actually, they're going to be rotating up top. So currently, Joe and Layla are going to be trying to push behind. The Scissors doesn't know where they are, and the Sniper's going to get caught out probably. What's going to happen here? Mist does get caught out, and Scissors does go down. So really well played there from Nunya. Yeah, they are sitting at 100% now. And the Force is going to come out from a nice sticky there from Ali, and it's just going to be soloed, but Husky has the much better Uber, and he's going to do well to get out here. And Layla does go down, nice drop down play there from Husky.
Yeah, I mean, from all of that, there was a lack of reaction from the Ragnarok combo. Like, when they moved underneath, they just stood in the same place for ages. They even moved the Sentry, the Red Sentry got moved, and they just stood there. They didn't capitalize on anything, and the weakest time a defensive team has is when they're rotating their positions, and they stood there and they paid the price because the spawn wave from the flank came in and cleaned the key players up in an ineffective Uber.
Yeah, and at the moment both medics died amidst that battle. Lazy Bear actually just got sniped as well, so both medics sitting around 40% Uber mark, and this is actually really good from Ninja. They've got really solid holds on almost all of the points, especially the last 2 points, so they've made up for that earlier mistake. Husky went down to a nice pipe there from Joe, and although Lazy Bear and Ali are trying to get that presence, Joe has now come forward to that full stairs. He's going to get some nice damage and then also push back the Sniper, creating less of those sight lines.
They're in a decent position right now, Nunya. They've got the top high ground. Joe doesn't lock off the front stairs. Scissors has managed to claim it. So Scissors actually does own that area, which gives Mist a chance to peek that angle and try and look for the pick. Joe actually deals with that. But it's a bit dangerous there, letting them have that front stairs area. Joe needs to really deny it.
Yeah, and Bacon also overextended onto the stairs. Didn't realise there was both the enemy demo and the heavy there. Got picked off straight away. So the solo Uber is going to come out on Joe, but they realise they have to back out. The Raggers players are now just trying to push the cart. They're focusing the cart. Husky goes down because they don't realise that Joe is still above, actually. He's going to get some nice damage onto the cart. Scissors is going to get onto Corndog, so the NG is going to be down. And it looks like it's going to be the final push. Layla goes down to a nice headshot.
Oh, Joe! But
Joe is playing massive plays here. Oh my god, did you see that from T-Time? That was oh my god, what was that? Jumped onto the cart, suicided, but managed to get the flame particles onto the player capping the cart and stopped it. Because Aura's now going to get onto the cart, and they're just delaying, you know, the final seconds at the moment. As Yumpu then jumps into the pit as well, trying to stop the cap. Raggers need to stop suiciding on the cart. They've got enough players up now to be able to block this, and they just need to build.
They missed their opportunity to cap, they completely ignored Joe at the top, and then they rushed the cart, no focus on Joe, easy spam onto the cart. They need to go retake top again, and pick players like Joe and the soldier, Jackie Legs on the high grounds. Pick them, get them out there, and then they can pressure the players that are just on the floor, make them come towards the cart. It's flanking underneath, look at Layla, a little bit alone. Oh, never mind.
Oh my god. Jackie Legs picking up three there, one rocket. And you know, they've made such a good recovery, and like so many times where it looks dire situation for them, they managed to pick themselves back up. I think it just shows the experience of them playing together for a longer period of time than this Raggers team. Really well played at the moment. I think Leia's on quick fix, isn't she? So she is at 100%. It'll be interesting to see if they decide to get aggressive with this, because obviously if they wait for the enemy team to get Uber, then it's not really the greatest thing to be holding up top. So Onkai is actually going to try and get aggressive up top. Joe's going to be very weak, and he's actually going to get dropped down there. So, you know, I don't know why Lelia's not using it. Actually, she does now pop the quick fix to save the remaining players. Husky's going to be aggressive onto the stairs, and Lady Bear's actually in a really bad position here. He's going to get picked off by Jackie Legs underneath, and I don't understand why Husky and Lady Bear were so far forward there.
Because it's such a bad time already, they're kind of rushing things a little bit, trying to get ground before the Uber. Really, they want to just make sure they get that Uber, because they probably just need one decent Uber push to deal with they can get frags and the sentry. That's probably what they're waiting for. But you know, Joe's in a great position. He's owning the front stairs. You know, he just kills three people. He knows that they're in basement as well. They've got control out over at every area at the moment. And you know, they're controlling every entrance. Although Joe does get picked there, he was a little bit too far. So it does.
Yeah, he couldn't escape from Surfs there. And the quick fix actually just got forced by Layla. I guess she took a couple of stickies from Ali, who was up top. But you know, it doesn't really matter. Like, you know, the quick fix healing base by itself is still going to be, you know, rather good. Lazy Bear is sitting at that 80% though, so they just need to do one good solid push, focus down those picks. As the conch aggressively comes out, and both the scout and the soldier were trying to go for the force there. And Husky is actually going to get aggressive up top now. The Uber's going to get forced really early there. Nice play there from Joe. And the backstab comes from Onkaya. So there's going to be no flanking play there. And actually, this is a complete mess. The Carlotto gets a pick on Husky as well. It's just Ali left up from that combo. Layla does get picked off, though. Nice play there from Scissors. But there's no presence on the cart whatsoever. No one's pushed it so far. And the sentry hasn't even been focused down.
They
even that's level
the
one.
Yeah, they just need to get the position and then get these players out that are behind them. Yeah, like that. Like Bacon, and then push the cart. Make sure everyone's in front of you. It's a lot easier to push that way. And here they go, running the car, but Joe's still alive, spamming. Onkaya drops down, takes out care of Joe, takes care of the medic. He should be able to clean these frags up. And there we go, they're finally going to get it. But this is going to be a brilliant time for Nunya. Yeah, 15
wow,
minutes.
Wow, almost 16
minutes. Seconds.
Just I mean, that's almost the maximum time, isn't it?
It's a really, really good time.
as Kronthug fights in chess, bye-bye chess. Wow, yes.
It is a best of three. It is a best of three. You don't really want to get players like...
And this is Nunya's pick as well, so I wouldn't really be, you know, shit-talking when they're winning on their map pick. Obviously,
it's early. Too early to be trash-talking, in my opinion. That's only going to fire them up to win more.
Yeah, and obviously, it kind of fits with what I said about how individually... you know, Raggers have almost more experience, maybe even more DM in some circumstances at least, which might show a bit more prowess when they play the CP map as the second map. Whereas Payloads, you know, requires a bit more teamwork, something that, you know, is gained over time playing with each other. So yeah, that's where Nunya have the advantage.
Yeah, they have practiced quite hard for this Nunya. I think what impressed me, even though I didn't agree with the way they gave up first for free, it's just the way they transitioned on between points. Like, they kept their combo alive every point they transitioned, which allowed them to buy a lot of time on every point. And you know, the Uber exchanges from Ragnarok have been, you know, they've managed to gain a little bit of ground, but they haven't got picks, and because they haven't got many picks, and their flank haven't got in a good position each time they Ubered. Oh, there's a crit straight away though, to start things off. So that's a statement of intent from Nunya.
And actually, Colosso's behind. Oh my god. He just ran into the sentry that was firing at the heavy. He was just about to backstab the medic and he ran into the spam.
Oh, Lazy's dropped everyone. Oh dear. Yes, they've got to give up first now. Hold second, next point. It was
Lazy Bear will be actually good, do well to get out here. I think Joe's trying to jump. He is going to try and jump behind them. He's getting good damage, and there you go, Lazy Bear goes down. Really well played there from Joe. He's going to survive, and Layla is going to still hold on. She's actually at 85% crits already. Like, they can definitely push solidly onto this second.
It's a good idea, you know, for the pace of the game. Say you have to make a decision now, and do it now. And Lazy Bear milked the Uber, good decision, but then they dropped everybody.
The crits has come early. And Alien Scissors, well. Yeah, that's really well played. Husky's the only one that might cause some damage there. He does manage to pick off Joe. And actually, they should back off to third now. I don't understand. I don't really agree with this hold that they're still doing. Husky's getting good damage
onto
Bacon, though.
No one's pressuring the sniper on the right. They don't want to lose too many people from their combo. But yeah, you're right. They should go to third, and they do it in the end. And so they've lost the first 2 points for free. So really, you know, they've got to hold 2 points with 14 minutes. Mentally, that's going to hurt them. They've really got to just focus on, their defense, 1 point at a time, one push at a time, because that's how you win these situations. I think. Remember a certain game on Upwood against a certain team, Samski?
I think we'll certainly remember playing. I think it was fair enough with Saini carrying, and what was it? We held on to loss. What was it? 11 minutes? 10 minutes?
Yes.
That was. I remember that. It is possible, and especially when you know this Raggers team. They had a similar time, maybe not as quick, but it was like 2-3 minutes onto the first 2 points. So they know that it's possible to hold it. They've just played against it. So they definitely know they can get a forward hold. And actually, excuse me, Gazul did a really good job there. He's still behind, but he did a really good job of spawn camping Joe. So as soon as Joe spawned, he backstabbed him, which delayed the push. And the medic is still on crits as well, so it's not really going to work without a demo. And the Uber does come out. The crits has been wasted. And actually, at this point, I would expect Layla to go back to spawn and get a different Uber.
Aphorex has been completely untouched and it just gets a sick headshot close range against Surfs. That's the sort of frag that Atomic would let you get. So I think they're definitely missing him. And, you know, the flank on Kaya and Kazul die way ahead of their team. So really big disconnect between flank and combo. And they've let them get this ground here. And they're pushing the cart. This is looking good. Can they win this next key fight that's coming up? The crits creeks at 90%, this is going to be key. If they can get the picks here, they're going to get this point.
Yeah, they need to go underneath. I think that's what Joe's planning to do. Actually, he's going to go up top and he's not hitting anything. Oh, I say that, he managed to pick up Ali. But Lazy Bear is sitting with the dispenser. So he's going to be at that 80%, and Husky's looking to get aggressive. The soldier on Kai is going to block the Uber and manages to get actually trade two. Husky is going to be able to clean up the frags, and the Uber is still sitting at 100%.
How
so
are they
really
doing
good recovery.
Oh, never mind.
Oh my god, Carlotto again. I think that's one disadvantage of Husky. Like, he's a smashing heavy and he does a lot of damage, and he has great aim, but I feel like sometimes a little bit tunnel visioned. And especially if Lazy Bear's not checking behind himself, you know, it prones yourself to getting, you know, a couple of stabs like that.
You can't do everything as a heavy. If you've got a medic behind you, you've got to be able to trust your medic to call those things for you.
And Joe and Jackie Legs literally just jumped into them, managed to pick up a three-piece together. Jackie Legs with the whip kill onto the sniper, and this is looking extremely promising. Lazy Bear has got 30%, so if they can build this quickly, and they are going to pick off Bacon as well, so that bodes well for them. It's going to delay the push, and the sniper's also going to get picked off. Layla actually goes down as well, but Lazy Bear then gets picked off by a flank from Tea Time. The frags are going left, right, and center. Joe's also going to go down, and I think Nunyara are getting a little bit ahead of themselves. They really need to just, you know, slow down the pace of the game. Layla should go back to Uber, and you know, they should just build this and then push forward as a team.
Yeah, I'm just watching the point of view of some of these newer players, like Mist, completely bumped into a spy, doesn't even look for him or call him, and Carlotto kills him 10 seconds later. Like, it's sort of this individual play by them, doesn't seem to be up to scratch. Ali's desperately trying to hold top as well, all by himself. You don't want to do that, you want to stay alive each phase of the game. On Kaya jumping into a heavy. Yeah, not smart decisions being made right now. I think the pressure's kind of got to them a little. This sentry's alive though, so if they can keep that up, they have a chance.
Yeah, but all they need at the moment is for someone to jump onto Cali, because the heavy is just spamming it constantly. Luckily, actually, the demo man is up for Raggers, so he might be able to deny. As Carlotto gets a nice headshot onto Surf, sorry, excuse me, I've just eaten, that's why I am belching.
Bit too many, much information. But,
that is actually 100%, and they're going to pop Uber, actually. So they're going to pop, and they're going to focus down that cart. Bacon's going to probably get picked off. A nice call out there, because all goes down, and they're going to focus down this cart. They just need to get the sentry down, and that's going to be it. A level 3 sentry protecting the loss. And it's with 10 minutes remaining. Are they going to push it? Are they going to push it over the edge? Ali is still alive, saving grace. But that is, the frags go in their way. Scissors is the only one alive, and he's going to get picked off by Yumpu. And with 10 minutes remaining, that's a solid push. Is it a best of one or a best of three?
I think we're about to find out. I'm pretty sure it's going to be best of three. It's a playoff game. But yeah, that was good play by Condog, who's getting a lot of love from the stream chat right now, because he put that sentry up main, forced Ali to focus it rather than focus the frags, which he really needed the frags, not, and That
wow.
made things life so much easier for them, but
I think Sizz is a bit salty. They're requesting a new server for the next side of Upward.
Maybe Husky's ping is a little high at 70, and you know, if you're in an environment where you've had a very bad push and people are complaining about the server, you know, it's going to affect team morale. It's going to, because you know your players are not 100% focused on the game. So I think it's a good decision as a leader to make sure they get a new server. It's probably the right thing for Sizz to do, you know, change the server, get your team to calm down for 5-10 minutes, then come back, you know, sort of stall the momentum. They did kind of just post the info in the server, so that's not smart play, Sizz, but it should be good. I like the way that they dominated the game, didn't you? You know, from the get-go, running crits, really big marker psychologically by Joe and Layla. No, and this the Ragnarok team just couldn't deal with the momentum. A couple of mistakes, and then on the third point, they almost held it. You know, when Colozzi got those two kills, they almost held it with like half their team. Onkaya traded for three people on the cart, and you know they cleaned up everybody else. Husky and the spy, like four people managed to deal with like their whole team, but then Colozzi came in and got those frags, completely changed that point.
Yeah, Colosso was, you know, I think it's probably about three or four times there. Just got a couple of chain stabs onto the heavy.
Huge.
Yeah, he went huge. I mean, let's take a look at the logs from the first game. If we can bring those up on stream for everyone else as well, that would be smashing. Let's look at who dominated that.
Yeah, we wait for the logs to go up. Just want to say from the Nunya team, you know, I think they've got a very decent shot of winning this. Today you were talking pre-game about the about their chances versus this team, you know, half chess team, but you've got to think, you know, this the key players for Chess Club in the way that they dominated last season's regular season was people like Atomic and Ubers on the flank were very, very key and solid and sniper, and they also had Quintosh as well, you know, a bit of an in-game leader. I'm not 100% sure he was an in-game leader, but he certainly got the personality of a leader, a character that can motivate your team. I don't know if it had the opposite effect.
Yes.
You know, they've lost all of those players, those very, very key players. They've been left with good players, experienced players, but you know, they've kind of lost a lot of their best players, and they've replaced them with just unknowns, really. And people like Mist wasn't impressing me. Cerse was getting killed by snipers and spies at close range. You know, it's going to be difficult.
Yeah, as we do take a look at the logs, we see that Joe Nuff with 39 frags, 660 DPM, and also Jackie Legs 481 DPM, 23-16. You also see Carlotso, Bacon, Fearax, the Spy, Heavy, and Sniper, 377 DPM for two of them, and 350. You know, extremely high damage numbers. In total, they did 17k more damage than the Raggers. So, you know, a lot of damage going their way, you know, a lot of frags going their way. They got over 50 more kills. You know, they're just giving themselves those opportunities to be able to push in by giving themselves a mana advantage, giving themselves that heal advantage. You see down at the bottom, you see when you look at frags, you see Kazul 6-26. You know, really underperforming there. You see Sizz as well, like, you know, once argued one of, you know, one of the stronger pyros in Prem. You know, 11-29, is that, I mean, you know, is that really what you're used to seeing? And, like, people are hyping out Corndog in chat, but, you know, he went 15-16-7, like a 4.4k Diaz NG. Like, he died 7 times on the server. That's the joint lowest deaths on the server with Layla. Like, someone that's doing that, like, staying alive, like, building sentries, just being a nuisance, is, like, actually doing quite a lot of work. Like, you don't really need to look at DPM when it comes to payload for NG. If he's dying, like, no times whatsoever, and he's getting a lot of assists and a lot of frags, then he's doing something right. So, really well played there.
Yeah, I mean, these stats do say a lot about the setup from Nunya, and I mean Layla and Condog both, you know, they're just not dying rarely, and people used to call out Layla, you know, she's bad medic, she does this, she does that, but you know, she's been staying alive, she's been improving. Last season there was some improvement. So far the performance has been reasonable from her, so there's some improvement there in their team. Lazy Bear's been having a problem. You know, their combo doesn't look synced. Ali doesn't seem to be very effective in this game, whilst Joe is completely dominating Precedence. Aetherex is dominating Colossus, you know, 25 picks to 6. I'm being told that Mist is actually Tutorial, who isn't really a main sniper by trade. Tutorial used backed up for us last season. I'm just going to confirm that, but Tutorial is it Tutorial? I want to check
wait,
this.
Wait,
no,
so...
no, it's not. It's Yarg, not Tutorial.
Yeah, it's Yarg.
Yarg, who's, you know, been quite highly rated as an upcoming player, but I think I put Aetherex above Yarg for all of Aetherex's problems with the last team he was on in high. You know, as long as he doesn't fall in love with Layla, he should be good on this team because he's a very, very good player.
Yeah, no, he highly impressed me, and he was one of the sole reasons, in my opinion, that Bureau did so well last season. He got so many frags, standout player in certain cases. But for me, like, MVP of, I mean, it's tight, but MVP for that map, honestly, is Carlotto. For me, anyway, the amount of drops that he got on the medic, I mean, Lazy Bear dropped 3 times, I'm pretty sure all of those were to Carlotto. The amount of, like, you know, synced up plays that he got either when they were about to push or, you know, he got them when they had a disadvantage, you know, those plays were really good. I mean, Joe played absolutely solid, you know, almost 40 frags, 660 DPM, you know, and Jackie Legs as well doing amazing flanks underneath, especially on that last point, picking up the medic a lot of times. You know, both of those players did really well, but for me, Colosso was the standout player for that half.
Yeah, he did very, very well for their team. I was just trying to see to make sure that we've got a new Source TV info. Have you got it, Samsky?
It's the same one, apparently, so I'm just going to retry to the server. Yeah, and we are on Upward once again, so that confirms that it is going to be a best of three. So,
That's good, because then, you know, they've got to prove themselves over 3 rounds.
Yeah.
There's one thing you can say. If you've got a team full of experienced players, you know, like Lazy Bear, like Onkaya, Scissors, Kazoo, who've all won championships, what you expect from experienced players is to adapt in-game, which isn't... You know, they might have got a hide in that first round, but maybe if they calm themselves down, talk about the problems in the first map, you know, they could get something going here, but I think a couple of players need to step their game up and stand and be counted. They've got to get their combo working together a little bit more. Ali, Lazy Bear, Husky got to work together a bit more, sync up a bit more with their flank.
Well,
Kazul, 6 frags, he really does need to begin being more effective in the game.
Yeah, I think also the problem is that Scissors would be more aggressive most of the time. I don't know if that's because he was getting frustrated, but he died the most on the server. And because he was dead, Colosso had a field day picking off their medic. Like, it was obvious that he could get onto their medic and their heavy quite a lot because they wouldn't turn around. And if Scissors is dead, then there's no one to check. Whereas T-Time, in my experience playing against T-Time, extremely passive pyro, and will probably just sit around the medic the majority of time. Maybe that's why Kazul is not being as effective as Colosso. Obviously, Colosso is playing with the Ambassador, playing a different kind of spy, you know, more comparable to Toast. Like, and I've always thought that out of all of the spy mains, lol spy mains, that Carlotto is probably, you know, one of those players that actually, if he cared about the game enough, which maybe, hopefully he is going to do this season, that he can, you know, come up to the standard of Toast that has set.
Yeah, I mean, he first, a couple of years ago in the first HONC we did, he was on the squad as a backup to Grungebomb, and it was very, very close between him and Grungebomb about who gets to start a spot. Grenger just about edged it because he's experienced, so he is a very good player, but he's kind of gone off the last few seasons. He didn't have a good season with Killswitch and has just gone underground since then, so it's good to see him back. But I still think Kazul should be playing much, much better. I mean, you're against Nunya, you're not against a team like Strong Opinions with Steve or somebody on Pyro. You've got to be able to get more into the game. You know, he has to come in and be a bit, get a few more valuable picks like Colosso is. But you do have a good point about Scissors. You know, maybe he isn't... He's trying to focus on getting things done rather than and I just do the basics right, which is what tea time is, just focusing on tea time, just focusing on, you know, trying to deny Ubers and trying to deny the spy.
Yeah, I think one thing that I have picked up on in the past, and I really don't want to have a go at players, especially when they're far more experienced, they've got more championships than me. Like, it's not really my position to do so.
It's okay, I'll tell you if you're right.
But I've always thought that Scissors is trying to follow in Steve Panda's footsteps as a pyro. And I think that, you know, there is no one like Steve, okay? And there is no one that has the mindset like Steve. The reason why Steve can be as successful as he is because he has the brain of Steve Panda, which is just incredible. He's so smart.
That's a fair point. I actually sort of agree with you, but Scissors as well has played for so long. He's actually probably the second best pyro in Europe, in my opinion, because he's been playing, competing against players like Steve and learning from him. So no, it goes a bit both ways. Of course, if there's the best player on the server at your class, of course you learn from him. But yeah, we've got the second round underway. It's Nunya on the offense, defense by for Ragnarok, and straight away they lose Husky to that man, Kalotso.
Yeah, we also saw Joe go down straight away, which meant the crits creep, which now has come out, got massively delayed. But it is over, and Lazy Bear still sits at the 100% Uber. But what he needs to do now is what he's doing now. He needs to be aggressive with that Uber. He needs to deny them. Joe is going to get headshot midair. Nice headshot there. And Jackalus is going to go down. This is looking like a much more solid hold after losing Husky at the beginning.
Yeah, Lazy Bear popped straight away. Didn't want to risk losing players in the Uber. But it does give Layla the advantage. It's going to be 20-30%. So it does make them have to think a little bit differently for this next push. See how it goes. Nunya are going to keep out the pressure, keep that heavy, you know, pressure on the car, keep the heavy shooting and make themselves targets, and it gives space for Afrex to get in positions like this. Picks off Surfs, and you know, Jackie Legs has got in on the flank as well, and yeah, they just couldn't hold the ground and Ragnarok, and they're going to lose the first point and lose the hill. So it's up to Joe to use his crits effectively, but the combo's in the tunnel. Joe's rotated. He's chasing these frags.
Magic a pipe.
Yeah, he's so close to getting this pick.
And Jackie Legs is behind them, actually. If they call out that they're in the tunnel, yeah, Bacon Knight is going to do well there. And Bacon is going to get picked up by Kazul, but that was really well played. They just need to call that out. Thing that you did notice, which I fortunately managed to capture, is that Kalotso actually did a really great play on that push. He managed to sap the sentry, but then also got onto the engineer and the sniper as they were trying to retreat, and just distracted them completely from the fact that, you know, and, you know, once you take away that sniper sightline, you know, Joe and Layla can just push forward, like, knowing that they're not going to get sniped, so...
Yeah,
really,
he's having a good game. Kalotso, contrast, Kazul failed, and we're in a great position to get a combo pick. Didn't get either, died, caught out by T-Time. You know, and this cart is being pressured again, and they're so scared to get forward. Ragnarok, I think they're just going to accept that they're going to lose second, focus on their third hold, which is, a good idea. Kalotso gets the cheeky kill on Kazul as well. Salt being rubbed into a large wound at the moment. But you know, they're falling back to third. They're in an okay position. Critscree coming out. First sticky is good.
And there's Scissors. And actually, if they just put a sticky in front of the sentry, then they're just going to be able to get this straight away.
They're going
to
use a super. Well, they've got to use it well.
The soldier's going to get onto the medic, actually. And Layla's going to go down to a headshot as well. So they don't actually need to use the super right now. They're falling back. But it depends how aggressive they want to go.
They want to use it.
Husky wants to go. He's going to get dropped, though.
Oh my god, what are they doing?
I'm pretty sure Husky would be annoyed about that. Having played with Husky, like, if he goes aggressive like that, he's expecting to get Ubered, and getting dropped like that is incredibly frustrating. They're also giving the Uber back towards Layla. I mean, she's only on 30%, but they're not using it in any way. They're playing extremely passively. The sentry is going to get sapped once again. Kalotso just causing havoc. The only saving grace at the moment is Onkai, who was hiding, but Bacon's going to see him, and Onkai's going to burn to death. So
still
no fight
advantage. They can still surprise them with the Uber right now if they use it now, which they're doing, yeah, but Layla's well out of there, so she should survive. Yeah, she's fine. So they are going to be able to at least hold this point for now, but they gave away an Uber advantage when they didn't really need to. I feel like they're missing somebody who's really in charge of this team. You know, this wouldn't happen in a team like with strong opinions or us, where there's a clear leader to the team. You know, half of their team are expecting to use a Uber, the other half are sort of being passive. There's a lack of leadership.
Uber's actually going to come out really early from Nunya, but they're going to focus down this sentry, or try to at least. But Scissor's actually doing a good job of denying Joe is going to completely fail at that attack on the sentry. Bacon needs to be aggressive here, but he's on half HP, and Husky's probably going to win this one-on-one. Might even pick up Layla as well. He does. That was really well played from Husky, but Bacon shouldn't have peaked that with such low HP. They are doing a good job of pushing up the cart, though. Husky's still on a tear, picking off Ferox as well, and Colotso and Jackie Legs both went down. Onkaya gets destroyed by Joe. Nice pipe there into the air. And TP Time is actually trying to get, and manages to get the force as well. I don't know how that happened, but they managed to get the force off. Lane just needs to stay alive now. They're trying to be aggressive, and Kazul is trying to, you know, get some damage, but he's not really going to do anything from that range with the pistol.
Yeah, it was a bit of a weak Uber from Lazy, to be honest. TP Time, there's nowhere near him, but at the same time, they've kept the Ubers relatively even. It's about 20%. It's a very small advantage for Layla. As you know, there was a good they got the defense in the end. I think that was Husky was the key there. Just, you know, he kited that Uber and then won the fight, kept his HP good, and just used it to effect. And they've got the car going backwards now. It's a much more comfortable position for them. But you can see they're trying to get players in top here right now. The heavy up top, trying to get pressure. But there's a soldier on Layla. On Kaya, great kill, gets the medic down. They can,
and Kazul's behind Joe as well. Joe might get backstabbed here, and he does. I was going to say, actually, one thing I did notice before he went down is Yao was on an 8 kill streak, Ferox on 2 points, not having a good game, and Colosso as well, 8 points. They're not getting the frags that they were getting in the first half, and I think that's completely slowed them down. You know, those pick losses not working as well as they were, and you said it yourself, you know, if Fraggers are going to turn this round, they have the composure and the experience to, you know, calm themselves down. So really well played here. They have turned it around, and they're setting up themselves for a really good time at the moment.
Yeah, Colosso's getting in position for a sap, and the demo is perfectly placed to sync this up. And the
Kazul's behind the medic as well. Kazul's behind the heavy, and the medic manages to butter knife him, and Layla should get picked off by the heavy. Kazul picking off a two-piece there, and this is a really good job. I don't know why they were trying to drive push there. They should have known that they had 100%.
I mean, dry push is an okay idea, but you said it yourself in the first round, you know, when Layla isn't next to Jojo, went on the cart to help that synced sap play, which was actually really good. Layla went forward into the choke point and got picked off by way too close to the medic there. So just giving them the frag and the Uber advantage, but here they go again, they're not letting up.
It's really well played. A really good controlled aggression from Husky as well to manage to pick off those. Kondog is going to be onto the NG, and he's going to try and get that sap. He does get that sap eventually down. Sentry's going to go down. It was only level 1 though. And that's going to cue the dry push. Scissor's trying to do a good job of denying the spam from Joe, but no one's on the cart at the moment. Surf's is going to milk the cart as well. Just be a nuisance. He's going to get onto the heavy. He's going to probably pick him off as well. Nice job there from Surf's to pick off Bacon, and Lazy Bear is actually going to hold back. Currently on 85%. They're going to give up this third, but they're probably going to get a good solid hold. The engineer went down quite early for the fraggers, so he's actually had that time to get back, and he's already positioning the dispenser and stuff. So he's going to be able to probably get a level 3 up before the cart is being pushed into the way, and both teams are sitting at 100% Uber.
Oh,
I say that, and Joe manages to drop Lazy Bear. Wow, that's going to turn it around.
You need your big players to come up with the big plays, and then go. Joe, NUFC, the best player on this team, delivers, and Jackie Legs is coming in as well. Gets the demo man down, so just got to work this SG down. NG's in spawn, they should pick this up.
This is looking good at the moment. Really good turnaround. Colotso is finally hitting those headshots that he is known for. And Jackie Legs should just, he needs to jump up and try and deny Lazy Bear and Husky. He's going to get a nice bomb there. Layla's going to go down. Lazy Bear's also going to go down. Husky's so weak underneath, he's probably going to get whipped to death. He does indeed. And actually, I said that this was going to be a really good time, but, you know, they turned it around. They that last point in 1 minute. And
smart from London. Yeah, they just chose not to use that Uber to try and buy time on third, which they could have done. It might not have worked, but they could have done it. Because they were 3 down, they went back with an Uber in the bank, which is a bit of a gamble. And the Nunya players, you know, they're 3 players down, they could get people in on the flank, including Jackie Legs, who dropped the medic. Jackie Legs been impressive me. I mean, Onkaya has did pretty well on that defensive round, but yeah, Jackie's been very, very solid. Like, his performance has been very good so far.
Yeah, and I think the last round stats on the stream are actually wrong. I think that was from the previous round. because it's from when Nunya were defending. So sorry for those stats on stream being wrong. Joe didn't get 31 frags on defense, unfortunately, on offense, sorry. So the player I want to see step up right now is Ephyrex. If they're going to be able to hold this in 8.5 minutes, he needs to stop getting outsniped by Yarg, because if Yarg keeps getting that entry, you know, entry frag onto the sniper, then they're going to be able to play a lot more aggressive, in my opinion. I think that's something that he did so well in the first half when they were defending. He got those picks. So let's see how this suicide wave comes out for them.
Yeah, but at the same time, you know, when you're playing defensive sniper, things are kind of at your advantage. So you'd expect that from Yarg. Ephyrex now has a chance to snipe as a defensive sniper, so hopefully he'll be more effective. But I think they're focusing him a little bit more as well. Is that... bomb is ineffective. It was slightly better synced up, but no one near Layla. Layla's on that health pack. When I used to play with my good friend Mookie, my best friend, he would say, okay, the medic Layla always stands on the same health pack, so I'm just going to do a jump into her. Hopefully Kaya should be able to recognise this. But instead of Ali's been sniped, so and there's a sap coming in too early, and attempted direct hit play, so trying to get the sentry down first. Seems to be their plan at the moment.
But the sentry is in such a place where direct hit's not really going to be able to hit it. The massive fan favourite Corndog, the god himself, has managed to position the sentry in such a way that, you know, Onkai would have to really overextend himself to be able to get onto the sentry. So, you know, well played at the moment. Ephyrex managing to pick off a Yarg. Husky going down as well. Some nice picks there. And another snipe. Really well played there from Ephyrex. Picking off a 3k right there. And the Conch is going to come out as well. Just going to be a nuisance. And they're delaying this push really heavily at the moment. Lazy Bear is still sitting at the 100%, but I don't think he wants to come out while that sniper is still ringing out headshots.
You see, there's a difference. And then you like to play with this point with the crits. Get aggressive early. Force a decision from the defensive team. Do we use this Uber? How do we use this Uber, etc, etc, whilst you see Ragnarok going for the suicide plays. You know, they're not committing their medic, they're trying to get picks before the Uber. Here we go, they've only got one pick to work with, and that's the sniper pick. And Stray's doing a great job, but they do work the sentry down, Ali.
And Bacon went down as well to the sniper, so they have lost a lot of players. Suddenly it's going in the favour of and Jackie Legs and Layla. Oh my god, all the frags, it's almost a wipe. Actually, it was a wipe. Those three players are all spawns, and it looks like they're going to go straight back to third. Yumpu is trying to pick off Kazul, but Ephyrex, the sniper, is already on third, as Yumpu actually finally goes down.
That's the importance, kids, of the after Uber position that you get, which is... what was I trying to say? Yeah, the after Uber position, you know, if they allow the flank to get in, it doesn't matter if you have a better Uber, if you allow the flank to get positioned on you, you're going to get crushed. I thought the Razorback was banned. Is a mist using it? Should it be banned? Maybe I've heard my rumours wrong, and I've been giving ETF2 admins a hard time for no reason, but isn't the Razorback banned?
No, actually, from the post that we saw today announcing the new season, it hasn't been banned. The only thing that did get banned was the...
I owe the admins an apology, and I would like to be the first to say I apologise for posting on the forums. Sorry, boys and girls. Continue with the game, sorry.
So at the moment we do see the Uber come out from the Raggers, but it's a really good job once again from T-Time to completely deny this. Hussey is actually going to go down to a nice reflect pipe there, and Ali fell all the way down to a nice play there from the sentry of Corndog, the god himself. So we are going to see Nunya settling down here really well. Jackie Lace is trying to be aggressive onto the cart, getting some good damage, and Kali's going to go down. Kazul is also going to go down, you know, at the moment, really good job there, really good defense when they didn't have that Uber, and now Layla is sitting at the 100% Uber.
Yes, I actually wasn't really watching that one. I'm just watching this after Uber fight. Layla actually doesn't even have the Uber right now. Nunya have been able to consolidate their position. They have the choice of using the Uber, you know, to get ground. They just need to stop this cart rolling forward. That's where Joe's focusing right now. Scissor's doing a really good job just staying alive and causing them problems. He's done really good in his third point, Scissors, you know, keeping the cart pressure and working the flank, giving another line of fire, forcing Nunya to try and focus on him. But his combo aren't really making effect of it.
Yeah, and Bacon actually went down to a nice headshot there from Yaug. So Yaug's going to be aggressive here, and actually he might get caught out. Jackie Legs popping off that conch. He's going to drop down onto him, and he's going to get picked off there. So really well played there. Kazoo's also going to get picked off. The Uber did come out from both teams, actually. Layla with the slight better Uber there, and the cart's going to be completely denied. It's going to be rolling back down, while Kazoo actually did use the dead ringer to get behind. But T-Time's actually going to pick him off here. And, you know, completely waste of an Uber there. The cart didn't get pushed forward anymore. Jackie Lacey's going to do a good job of denying Surfs from getting anywhere more forward. Actually, he gets his, get picked off by Scissors there, so a good frag there.
Bad Uber, dropped Husk at start, ran him straight into a Pyro, ineffective. Jackie Legs was behind him the whole time with Conch. You know, you've got to make sure that you're not being flanked. You know, when you're pushing a point, you want everyone in front of you. I've said this already. You don't want people behind. And but they've actually managed, in between you, but they managed to get the ground for free. They've been let in by Nunya because they lost Joe, and they kind of gave that up for free. And Layla actually got picked as well. I didn't see that.
Neither did I actually, and the cart's going to be pushed onto a third point there. Ali is actually going to get picked up by a Ferox there, but Scissors is actually trying to kill the heavy. Oh my god! But he was trying to kill the heavy while he was eating the sandwich, but he didn't realise that T-Time is also there. T-Time completely. The Uber actually got forced by whom?
Scout behind, yeah. But it was a weak pop. He didn't even hit him once. 150 HP, Lazy Bear just popped it. He's panicking a little bit. Not a natural medic main. A natural medic would have probably, you know, tested Yompu and said, if you're good enough to hit me.
Yeah, and Joe's actually going to get picked off by Surfs underneath, so this defense of the car is looking dire. They still have to defend it for 2 minutes and 12 seconds. We've seen them do it before, this scrappy holds on last. But this time, Lazy Bear is still alive, and Surfs is on the cart right now. Bacon needs to be aggressive onto the cart, but Surfs is still on it. No one is denying him whatsoever. Finally, he does go down, and Layla is going to survive, but she stands still to try and crossbow the heavy, and Yaga's going to punish her for that mistake. The medic does go down, and Lazy Bear is once again going to have that Uber advantage. And right now, you know, they have time just to build up their Uber, and just get that advantage. They still have the top advantage. Joe is going to overextend and go down, but nice headshots there from Carlotso and Aferix to pick off Ali and Mist. And right now, you know, it's a bit messy. Both teams are just suiciding onto the
red
point.
Red team are fine, though. I mean, they might have Joe down, yes. A couple of good frags there. They might have Joe down, but, you know, they've got people up top. The soldier. Oh, Kaya's actually in. He manages to win a fight with the spy, as he should. Now they're kind of losing top now, and there's a good position here for Ali to trap their combo lower. It's going to be an interesting fight.
Jackie Legs actually popped the conch underneath. He's going to get onto Husky the heavy, going to get some good damage, but as you said, they are going to be holding up top now. They have given up that space and has allowed Joe and the heavy and Layla all to get up top. Layla actually building much quicker than Lazy. Lazy had a massive advantage. He has lost that. And so many weak players at the moment on the Raggers team.
Carlotso just gets 1v1 by... Sorry, 1v1 said Demoman.
They changed the map, which is extremely rude of them, but that means I assume that Nunya took that map, because that's the only possibility that they would have changed the map for it.
Yeah, it's disappointing we didn't see how that happened, but it was kind of coming, you could say, the way the game was going. But it's disappointing nonetheless, so... You know, and it's chess server, so... Thanks, Scissors.
They're probably a little bit salty that they've lost the first map. So, you know, we'll forgive them. And they'll probably have...
That's disgusting.
They'll probably have fun playing in high next season anyway, so, you know.
But, you know, that's a big win for Nunya. They just look more together. Like, Joe's their clear main caller. You know, he's leading the team. No, he's making sure that they get the most out of their Uber fights, giving them direction. And Jackie Legs has really fitted into the flank well, because he's able to dominate. Now he's got the deathmatching skills to hold his own, so he's not the kind of player that just gets, you know, walked all over, which you can see in some of these low prem teams with their flank. Now he's able to do a great job. So they've got good players in the combo, good players in the flank, and they've got a good sniper, a good spy. They look like a kind of like a proper team. I think they should take this. It's a different test, obviously, Gullywash, but they have players that are capable of doing things, you know, and they have a clear caller. So they look a good team. Not sure if they're going to be able to be challenging for the championship, but I think they have enough to win this game.
It's going to be interesting to see if they're this good after only a couple of weeks of playing with each other. you know, I think that, you know, any team that Joe makes, people get surprised by how well he puts them together. I know for certain, I've played with him in a UGC season, and, you know, with players that, you know, arguably weren't as strong as some of the other Prem teams that were in UGC. Some people think that UGC is a joke league, but there were serious teams. We played against Strong Opinions, yeah. And we won in the third, fourth place match for that. And, you know, Joe has that ability to be able to, you know, call and project his voice and, you know, control a team that, you know, other people might think, oh yeah, they're not as good players, but, you know, as yeah. a team, they work much better. You know, as and shown last season as well, they played yeah. out of their minds.
And even though he's playing in a team that are kind of mid-prem, he is the best demo man in the league as well. That does help. I mean, I don't say that lightly, being a demo man, but he is the best demo in the league. He is playing with Layla, so people kind of give their team a bad rep. But if you look at the performance in this game from Lazy Bear, and compare it to Layla, there's not really much between them. Layla's made a few mistakes, but Lazy's, you know, he looks nervous. Lazy, he's popping really early when he's not pressured. He's making, you know, he's dropping a couple of players. And whilst, yes, Layla will do things like stand still when there's a sniper in play and, you know, and occasionally make the odd mistake positionally or, you know, not be able to dodge as effectively, there's not really much in them. So Medic isn't really the class that's going to win you the game. What you need is strong leaders, good players like Joe, a good sniper that's dominant, a spy that's dominant, Jackie Legs, a good flank player that's dominant. So Layla's doing okay. So people should stop giving her a hard time because there are other medics that aren't performing.
No, yeah, I completely agree. I think actually Layla had a rather good game, and especially on the first side, like 6 deaths, the least deaths on the server. You know, you can't really argue with that. She played really well. So people really need to stop calling out her, just probably just because she's a girl medic, because she gives Joe a lot of heals. Well, funnily enough, you know, if you give someone a lot of heals that's getting 600 DPM, then, you know, usually they're going to win the match. So, you know, it's not a bad strategy. It's just like you saw with Breakfast Junior, where he got a lot of heals on the first time that Chess won the season. You know, it's the same concept. Like, if you give a lot of heals to your carry player, then they're going to carry you, and that's exactly what, like, so I don't understand why people shit talk for giving a lot of heals to Joe.
Well, the other thing is, I guess Bacon also is quite a vocal player. People don't realise Bacon's a vocal player as well, and he's got to work well with, he's going to be able to work with Joe, not having as many heals, and he's doing a decent job, because he knows he's not going to be getting the focus from his team, Bacon. He's got to be a support player. But speaking of support, Samski, it's time for some mid-map plug-in. So we've had a good pre-season so far. We've got some pre-season playoffs coming up. Blackout are going to try and bring you every game live. Who's in the other games?
We have, I think, Premtech versus the Bureau, like the Bureau's son team, or, you know, baby team, the Budget Toucans. And then the other match is going to be Fair Enough versus Sandwich's team. I can't remember what the name of that team is.
Yeah, the I can't remember as well.
They were in Prem the like 2 or 3 seasons ago.
Their name is Super Dickman.
Yes, Super Dickman. That's it. Yes, Canon.
Something
yeah.
like that. So yeah, those are some great games coming up. Also going on as well in the world of TF2, there is actually a new news website out there for people that don't know. It's called thespire.tv. I'll post the link in chat, but it's a website that's dedicated to giving you coverage of all levels of TF2. You know, there was some talk about Team Fortress TV, you know, abandoning the lower levels, but, you know, Highlander's going to get lots of love on that website, and you're also going to see coverage of 6v6 on the website as well. Button Notice has kind of been project manager of it. Gentleman John has been programming it, and there's lots of people contributing to it, including CJ, who's done a pre-season article previewing these playoffs. So check it out. I'm going to start linking it in chat to you guys. Have you heard of this? Oh, we're going live, Samski.
Yeah, I have heard of the Spire, and actually I think it's a great idea, especially when I saw Button Notice saying that they were going to be casting games from high. So, you know, it gives that opportunity to players that aren't in Prem, you know, to get that exposure, And it also gives a good opportunity for teams maybe to see like new upcoming players, like when they don't really get the spotlight unless they're in, you know, certain circle jerks. As we do in the first mid, and Yuppie's going to be extremely aggressive onto Ali. Great bomb there from Onkaya to pick off the scout, and Joe's going to immediately go down to Husky. And this is already looking like a mid in the favour of the Raggers.
The Raggers, never get. I guess some of the people from Scandinavia won't get the kind of slang term that is in some parts of Britain, the Raggers. But you know, they Ragnarok showed their dominance on that mid, so definitely a different test. But they did get Lazy Bear down, and Layla got out to her credit. She couldn't really get anywhere, so she just went back to last. So they do have a chance to recapture second.
Well, I mean, in sixes, recapturing second is difficult enough, and that's versus six players. Versus nine players, I mean, unless you get, like, most of them down, I don't think it's really possible. I say that, and Kolitsa gets a nice stab onto Scissors, just misses out on the medic there, but it does manage to survive, and the Uber's actually going to come out from Layla, while Lazy Bear is way out of there. Nice stab there onto
last.
Joe.
Kazul versus Condog on last. It's Revolver versus Rescue Ranger. None of them have hit each other at all.
And actually, the god himself is going to be taking that. He has taken no damage, Kazul missing every one of his revolver shots. While that happened, Layla went down, Bacon went down, Joe went down, and Affix went down, and that's looking like the push is going to be happening rather soon. The sentry does go down to Akali. Surfs gets fragged in the meantime, but it looks like it's only inevitable that this point is going to be captured, and it does indeed.
I mean,
really solid.
Kazul completely choked there, missed every shot. In fact, he's blaming the 700 ping that Condog has. So I think what happened is Condog was lagging and he couldn't hit him, but at the same time, you know, you've got to win those fights. But I'll give Kazul a break. 700 ping is, he could be warping, but it's harder for Kazul, Condog as well. But yeah, they failed the Uber out and they got punished. Happens a lot in TF2.
A lot of people in chat are saying that this is, because this is a 6th map, it's going to be over very quickly. But this mid, the frags are going in a complete different direction. Jackie Legs and Kolitsa are going to both go down, but those are the only frags. How was that a backstab? I just saw Kazul face stab the scout. Husky's going to get completely caught out there, completely overextending, but Kali is actually snuck behind. Scissors and Kali are both hiding behind. Layla has no idea, and actually they timed that extremely badly, and the mini sentry is actually going to pick them both off. Scissors actually going down to tea time.
Yeah, they got spotted and Layla reacted in time, so good play. In the end, you said they timed it badly. But are people actually saying, because it's a 60s map, they're going to win? What? What is wrong with these people? Everybody playing in this server is probably played 60s at mid or high. A couple of Prem players in there. Doesn't mean anything. This is Highlander, not 60s. It's all about how you use your brain.
Yeah, and actually, Ferex did a really good job there of getting onto Big Door quickly while they were still capping. Managed to get that snipe onto Yaug from Peking. And, you know, once you get that sniper down on second of Gullywash, there's no real threat. Because you can't really get any of those long-sighted, you know, long sight lines that you can from the door.
As they're trying to go underneath.
And Ali picks off too, and the Uber's actually going to come out straight away. But I don't really agree with this. They haven't focused any of the frags. The combo is still alive, but they have got time on the point. And what? Husky and Ali, they were just standing there waiting, looking at the Uber, and then realised, oh god, they're actually on the point now, and that was the end of it.
Well, they did manage to get a few picks. Whilst they didn't actually touch the combo, because they didn't have Uber at Ragnarok, they couldn't really contest them. And Husky's a very slow class, and they just, you know, focused the point, got the results, but it's mid-fight, Big Door rollout, this is going to be an aggressive play by Ragnarok.
Joe's going to go down straight away, but he gets two pipes onto Ali and Kali. The NG and the Demo both going down there. At the moment, Etheric's probably going to get picked off, but actually, you know, he's going to survive, because all missing, once again, all of his shots. Kali went down to a backstab from Kolitsa. And Kazul and Miss went down, so that must have been a spy dead ringer on the second pipe that Joe got.
Yeah.
Because Kali died twice on that mid, and I don't think that's
a bit lucky. I didn't see whether or not Joe was actually aiming, but it's smart by him. If they're going to rush you on the left as a demo man, what you got to do is get passive positioning and just spam the choke point that their combo's trying to enter, and I think he did that, and he got enough damage to justify his death, and his team were able to clean up. So it's a good way to start the middle, Joe, getting the damage needed, and the team are capitalising on it. Lazy Bear is dead, so full Uber advantage. It's about converting your Uber advantages to get the round leads, to see if they can do it.
And actually, they're going to go exactly where Scissors was holding, but they actually managed to force him to drop down. So actually, good job there. And they're going to focus the cap. Husky is actually down below, and that's going to fail completely as Surf's managed to pick off two, and Layla gets picked off by Ankaya. And Bacon's probably going to get picked off by a body shot there. So the conch has come out from Jackie Legs, and I think he's actually going to go underneath. They don't realise this, and actually he's going to demolish this. Oh my god, I couldn't pronounce my words there. He's going to destroy the sentry, and he just survives with a couple of HP. But there is so much time on the point now that it's going to be a risk for this team. And he actually picks off Surfs, so eventually he may go down. He does eventually go down. But he's given his team so much time to get in position, and there's so much cap time as well, that,
there's a lot of different...
They're not going to be able to push now.
A lot of different phases. Yeah, the cap time's making it hard, but there's a lot of different phases of get play that have been going on. Bad Uber, no frag, straight into Scissors, rushed it. And then, defensively, there's a pyro on the point, actually. Tea time's going to get cleaned up, but defensively, now, when you watch football and you watch teams defensively be so deep, that's kind of what Ragnarok are doing. They're not pushing out and holding entrances. And they have Uber advantage. They should just trust the one or two people they're leaving on the point and push out. You can't be this passive, because you're just going to give Nanya another go at pushing you.
Yeah, and Layla has crept up onto that 100% Uber, so it's going to be equal Ubers there. Ankaya was trying to do some sort of, improvised jump there to try and get onto the mech, but got immediately headshot, and actually he's going to be quite weak right now. So no suicide is going to come onto the medic. He's always trying to... Actually, he does manage to sneak behind and manage to pick off Bacon. So that's going to delay the push for Nunya at the moment. But, I just don't really agree with this passive play. Usually Chess Club are quite aggressive. I don't know if that's because Quintosh is quite an aggressive demo man. But, this is a completely change in play style that I'm used to seeing from, the same players.
I suppose as long as you keep that capture point in your favour, it doesn't matter too much. Maybe they're waiting for the better opportunity, but now they're pushing into a lobby, so it seems as if they want to give themselves a chance to push, and then you just drop outside, actually holding combo on the riverside. If it's Uber v Uber, what you want to do is have some sort of advantage to push out, which they don't have at the moment. When they had Uber advantage, that was their time to go, in my opinion, which they've left, so staying on last is fine, but here comes a jump. Looking for that force, Layla, pressured by a spy as well. Lazy Bear, not Layla. Last map he was panicking, popping. This time he knows the importance of keeping that Uber alive, and he doesn't. Good play.
Yeah, and Ferex managed to pick up on Kyra as he went aggressive, so Layla's managed to hold on to that Uber. Kazul is behind the combo, actually. Might be able to get something, but Layla's spotted him out. She's actually just holding the Uber, and she might drop here, and she does drop. Layla saw that, a long time. I don't know why Joe didn't turn around at all. Completely let Layla down there, and she did drop, assuming that someone was going to protect her. nice jump stab there onto Ankaya, managing to pick him off in lobby. And at the moment, the frags are rather even.
Yeah,
the force does come out, and there's a level 3 outside. It's probably going to get picked off by Scissors, as she's going to be taken back, so Kondog's going to save that level 3 sentry for mid. And second point is now for the taking. But Nanya don't want to give this up, and actually it's just the sniper left on second.
Yeah, T-Time's done a good job, was pressuring a combo in the lobby, forcing them back inside to protect Lazy Bear, and it's allowed Nanya to get on the point. Yeah, Layla probably should have popped there. Because, if you're going to drop Uber, you're going to drop Uber. But at the same time, Lazy Bear had an atrocious Uber. There was a soldier in his face. He did, before he took any damage, he popped again. The soldier's using the black box. You've got to trust your ability to dodge it and try and milk the Uber. He's going to hit the first rocket on you, but then you're going to surf. So I think different phases of play. Medic's having a big impact in the game, but the same result, Nunya pushing last.
Joe actually just went down to a sticky trap there, am I right in saying? I think so, yeah. So he did, so that's going to delay the push. But both medics are sitting at 100% at the moment. Ferex manages to pick off the soldier of Ankaya. But Layla's just going to sit outside and wait for that spawn of Joe. Corndog actually going onto the medic, face taps him, body shots him twice, but gets piped in the face by Ali. And that's going to be the end of that. Bacon also getting pit off by Yogg. So, the frag's going in the way, and fraggers look like they're going to want to push out here.
Yeah, they've got a few picks, so now is a chance to exchange them. They're all stacked in this big door. One solo Uber in this big door and a heavy or something. If they can make sure tea time doesn't there, they could get a lot of damage done. Instead, they're going top to avoid being forced early, I'd imagine. They're taking too long about this, in my opinion. But there's a sap on the sentry, but there's no support from the... Oh no, here comes the support. This is good, they've got ground now, and none of too many picks have been lost. This is... a flank Uber, it's inadvisable. Layla's running away, scout going behind to try and draw people back. But they should get this point, yeah? Good play.
Yeah, and Yumpu's actually having a great game at the moment. Currently on an 8 kill streak, Jackie Legs was also doing good damage onto Husky. He's going to force him to go back. And Yumpu's just being a nuisance at the moment. He's going to finally get patted down by the club. He has given his team enough time to get back onto that mid. And the Uber's actually quite equal, Layla managing to stay alive there.
Old-fashioned cookery frag. Nunya weren't able to Uber any of their heavy classes, and it kind of shows when you don't have your heavy classes, it's not valuable to use your Uber, generally. I mean, they did manage to get the... I think they were just a little bit too desperate to hold on to the point, whilst they could have forced that Uber from... Because Lazy Bear popped first, I think. No, sorry, he didn't. So never mind, my line of thought doesn't matter. So now, new test for Nunya. Can they push second? With equal Ubers.
Yeah, I think they're going to wait for a pick. Carlotso did actually go down there, so, you know, not a great start. He was trying to get behind them, because Kazul was actually behind as well. So let's see if he can get anything done. I'm currently spectating, but Tea Time is well aware of this. She's going to immediately get a flare onto Kazul. Kazul's going to get picked off at Big Door. And, you know, they seem very comfortable at the moment, just to be holding and waiting for Husky to peek in, wait for that sniper to get a pick at Big Door.
And then you're playing they're playing the waiting game. They want to wait for players to get picks rather than an Uber. So that seems to be their plan. But if that's their plan, they've got to, you know, support people like they've supported Afrex here. He's got the entry frag on York, so now they have a sniper. They're giving frags away here. They don't have to be defending this choke point so close, and they're allowing Afrex to peek. And they're walking into a sightline. Yes, they forced the Uber, but they've lost Husky, and they've lost Kazul here, and they're going to get forced. Solar Uber on the demo man. The scout needs to come in and get involved in the fight. He's not doing that, so they could get surrounded here and wiped. It's the danger.
Yeah, and Lazy Bear's going to get picked off, and really very well played there. And Layla was completely passive there at Big Door, staying with her combo. You know, really good job there. Yumpu was just getting time on the point, you know, pressurizing the Raggers team to make a decision whether to get out or not. And that's going to be the end of that. Serp's managing to win that scout one-on-one there. And at the moment, it looks like Layla's actually going to peek in. Strange decision there. She was on 70%. She could have just waited for that Uber. And actually, the Fraggers are going in the Raggers' favor. And yeah, that's going to be the end of that push.
I think that's a bad choice by probably Joe, his main call in, to, you know, when they have Uber advantage, to call your team in rush last. It's kind of a mistake that... lower team mates, generally higher teams don't, you know, they don't rush pushes like that. They generally trust the Uber advantage. So mistake by Nunya. They such a good play setting that position up, and they've thrown it away. Although I guarantee players like Atomic would have taken it. Oh, there's a flank behind. They're pushing straight back in, Nunya. They don't want to lose this point.
Really good job at the moment. Husky did go down, and so Joe did get fragged off. Actually, it's a really bit messy at the moment. All of the frags are going back and forth. The Uber did get forced out there from Lazy Bear, but Lele did go down, so it's going to be, you know, kind of a free Uber. As they do to be able to push onto mid now, they're playing really solid together. Corndog still at Big Door, trying to build a level 1, but that should get cleaned up straight away. And it looks like now it's going to be Nunya's time to hold second point.
Yeah, they did exactly the same mistake they did in last. They rushed in. Joe kind of traded his life rather than staying alive, and then they kept them comboing too long and ran, and all Lazy Bear had to do was hit right click. Attempted bomb by Jackie Legs, good play by Kaya to spot that and deal with it. So now the momentum's completely switched, and you have kind of thrown away 2 points. Now they're going to be stuck on last with a Uber disadvantage. We're going to see if Ragnarok are better at pushing last than Nunya.
Yeah, and this is actually a really good chance now for the Raggers to push in. They have a 50% Uber advantage, and, you know, if they can get the lead on this map is not the easiest to make a comeback on. especially in Highlander. Onkai gets a nice opening two frags onto the combo, and this is looking really good. Husky's going to be pushing onto the point with the pyro. They're going to be able to push the people off the point. Husky absolutely dominated, but Colotto hit three headshots in a row, absolute dominating fashion. But in the end, just too many frags going in the way of the Raggers, and it's going to be 2-1. It's looking promising for them to go to a third map.
Nice try, but they executed that so much more better than Nunya. They can get frags, get position. And when you push last viewer advantage, you want frags, or you want to get people in really, really good positions. And they managed to do that. So 2-1. Nunya need a big mid here, or they're going to be chasing the game again.
Yeah, they really need to take a... And that's a good good start, Joe getting the opening pick onto Cali.
Deadringer.
But, it's the Deadringer once again, so I'm going to get get caught out by that. But actually, Nunya are really passive. Hussey's actually going to get picked off there as they look to get aggressive. Frags is going to go down. Joe's going to go down to a Nightbest out there from Kazul. And at the moment, the Frags are going left, right, and centre. Kondo's going to try and get aggressive. Layla actually surviving at the moment. Kazul is trying to pistol her down, and she's also on fire, but Bacon's doing a good job of denying this combo from pushing forward whatsoever, even though he is so weak. Layla's going to get headshot though by Yarg, and that looks like it's going to be the end of this mid, unless something miraculous can happen. Jackie Legs gets a nice force off there from Banana, and Colotto also standing there, and at the moment they just need to use this Uber
mid's
effectively.
Mid's not over. If they lose a couple of frags here, you know, there's a spy. And
Bacon's actually underneath, and I think Colotto's going to completely bait him there. And he did. He completely baited the frag there. Cali picking off Bacon. Layla's going to get picked off.
Mid's over.
Yeah, the mid is over. That's going to be the cap. And with 13 minutes left, it's certainly not, you know, impossible. But, you know, they have to then push onto mid. They have to push on second. They have to push onto last and make a successful last push, like, twice.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be very difficult for Nunya to, you know, they need to get that momentum back.
I mean, the good news is that they're going to be able to hold them to second, so they still got a chance. But that mid was... Scissors, I think he did a drop-down rollout or something, because he managed to get behind them on choke. Totally confused their team, like, T-Time was fighting him 1v1. Layla wasn't aware, backed into Scissors, almost got fragged, and then their team just got confused because of the pressure. And they stood so far back, they allowed Ragnarok to get an entry way back into the mid, because they started the mid poorly. They lost the demo man early, stalemate. So
yeah.
I think we're going to see patient play from Ragnarok. I think they're just going to wait. They did have a slight advantage, but I don't think they were dependent on it, especially the positioning of Nunya is best set up for an Uber advantage.
Yeah, and Colotto is behind, but by the way, that Husky was spy checking. I'm pretty sure they know that he's there. Like, Husky keeps firing behind. They're pretty sure that there is something behind. Kazul does get, the Deadringer activated to try and go behind, but nothing as of yet. And Jackie Legs actually going to go drop down, so we need to watch onto this. Jackie Legs going to jump up now, going to get a nice rocket onto Lazy Bear, but the second one's going to hit Husky, and he's going to get picked up by that mini sentry. And that's going to be the end of that suicide wave. We might see the same thing from Onkai, looking to get aggressive onto that big door. But for the moment, it's a really stalemate situation. Colotto just playing his time. He's just trying to make a wait for a distraction play to go in and get that pick.
They seem very, very sort of Ragnarok. Like they're playing in a way where they don't want to they don't want to lose their lead. They're not looking for that third round, because, you know, if you can pick get a soldier pick, that gives your team a license to be aggressive on flank. And they're not doing that. Like, the only player they seem to be prepared to lose is their spy. So they definitely... Oh, here comes Jackie Legs again. This time there's a spy pressuring Lazy, and he drops the second rocket. And yeah, that's what I mean. Like, if you're going to sit there and consolidate a lead, it opens that chance up every time. And this is a great chance now for Nunya.
Yeah, they need to work. Watch out. Joe is actually going to get onto Ali. And
people hiding in the banana, coming in now onto the medic.
And Yarg actually gets the headshot onto the medic. Runs into a pipe though, so he's going to get picked off straight away. And there is a level 3 sentry on the field, onto mid. That was a really good bomb there from Jackie Legs. Man, just getting two nice rockets. But this mid fight is not over, actually. Jackie Legs is going to get some nice rockets onto Cali, and that mini sentry is doing work actually on the floor. Scissors is going down to the level 3 sentry, and that's going to be the end. The cap going to go in favour of Nunya.
The level 3 though, by Gondok, is quite... It's cheeky, because he's pushing it in after the... it's an old strat on 5CP, pushing it in after the combo's committed. He was able to win them that fight. Kazul's got to be focusing on Condog, I think. Just take that out of the play. You know, get rid of his idea. That's how you probably want to think about denying it. But yeah, Joe, I think they didn't spot the people hiding in Banana, and that's how they lost their medic. And then, yeah, you know, Joe was looking to chase frags forwards. When you're really in that situation, you want to consolidate your position. You know, you have your advantage anyway. So look for the flankers, keep your medic alive. And they barely won that fight in the end. And the Eagle Ubers as well.
Yeah, I mean, this is died down. The action has completely died down from the first map and even the beginning of this map. So getting, you know, real stalemate at the moment. I think the Raggers, you know, they're playing so passive because they know they have the advantage, so they're not going to give anything away. We do see Carlotto actually behind, and the Uber is going to come up. Laserpair is going to drop Husky, though, and at the moment, Carlotto is just playing behind. He knows there's a couple of people around, but he has actually got spotted, so he's going to do well here to get a pick when everyone is away. I say that, and he's going to be behind the medic, and he's going to get the backstab, and Mist is going to go down on as well, and Ali, and that's a really good recovery there. Carlotto managing to get that stab, and Onkaya also gets taken off by Jackie Legs.
Just, Kazul came in when the fight was over. No, he's still alive behind them. I doubt he'll get anything done. They seem to be aware of him. But Kazul came in when the fight was over. Carlotto came in during the fight, got the key kill. And also in the Uber exchange as well, they got players, you know, they got players in the choke point. So they got players into seconds, so they couldn't hold them in the choke point, Ragnarok. And in the end, they surround them and win the fight. Layla with Uber advantage, but they've been bad pushing with Uber advantage, but they have got a couple of entry frags. So this is a really good chance for them to win a round. Back cap though.
Yeah, there is a back cap from Kazul at the moment, and they're not contesting it, and they're not focusing the point on last, and actually the caps. Oh, it finally gets blocked there, I think. So the point and just doing a lot of damage, hitting so many damage, and the level 3 from Corndog, the god himself, managing to pick off 3 people. Really well played there, and it's going to be 2-all.
Oh dear me. I mean, that was a good try by Kazul, you know, to try and split people and force people to make a decision to go back, but that level 3 from Corndog has won them 2 points. It won the middle and it won them last there. they've got to do something about it. They get him out of the... Stop him from building those level 3s and stop him from being effective, because, you know, once you destroy it, he's wasted 2 minutes of his life building it up.
Really, really good play there from Corndog. Somehow that level 3 working out, and a really aggressive mid here from Nunya. Getting loads of frags. Joe getting really aggressive onto their big door, getting off Onkaya, and they have fallen well out right now. They need to keep Laserbear alive. You know, there's 7 minutes left. They can definitely hold on to this, but the conscious come out. They're going to look to get aggressive, looking to get onto this point. Ali's actually weak on top as well, so he's going to do well to get out. Joe's getting some nice stickies onto him. He is going to fall out eventually. And Medic and Heavy are still holding in lobby, so it looks like they want to do some sort of forward hold at the moment.
Yeah, being at 2-2, 6 minutes, 30 seconds left. I wouldn't bother holding forward. I'll just try and consolidate your position on last. They're losing people. They might be forced into a bad Uber here. They're not paying attention to the door. Lazy Bear just about pops in time. They have to consolidate. There's a spy coming in. Oh, they just spotted him. Yeah, they're in a bit of a mess at the moment, positioning-wise. They could take this.
Yeah, but Layla actually gets picked off by Kazul there. At the moment, there's a lot of players underneath, and they might actually get this cap. They've got a pyro on the point, and they do, actually. It's going to be 3-2. Really well played there. I didn't see the pyro, and Joe were actually both underneath, and they just, you know, used that stickies and the air blast just to blow everyone off the point, and they're going to get that cap with 6 minutes remaining.
Yeah.
Now it's the Raggers' turn to be aggressive on this mid. They really need to get back into this game, otherwise they're going to be stuck in high, and I'm going to laugh at Scissors.
Bless him, but... Yeah, I think Husky takes the blame for that. He ran into the stickies of Joe. He should have just stayed alive, focused on that. Joe's, again, he's spamming that choke point, and they're trying to rush up the right side, and he's done lots of good early damage. So it's going to be difficult, but not really much presence from Nier so far. And yeah, there we go. Colotso in behind on Lazy. And that's going to be, you know, you haven't got the medic frag. The mid's not over yet, but Layla's doing a smart thing with Joe and the pyro. They're just keeping the medic alive, because if you can keep this medic alive, you're going to have an Uber. You're going to be able to defend points, or attack points.
Yeah, no, this is a really smart decision, actually. Because, to be honest, they know how difficult it is to push onto all of these points. So if they hold that Uber, you know, they're just going to delay them even more. Now they know that Leyteber has to get that Uber. That's going to be another 50 seconds to build it. And, you know, it's just more and more time wasted. 5 minutes remaining. Yumpu actually goes down on the flank. So there's an NG pick. And Mist actually picks off Colapso as well. Actually, no, that was a Deadbringer. So
they got the level 3 down there.
Do they have a level 3 up?
Corndog, they Kazul focused it and took it down. So, you know, no level 3. That's something they can work with. And Nunya don't look like they want to push this. I mean, it is going to buy them time. But, no, at the same time... I mean, I guess they're saying to Ragnarok, are you good enough to break us? Which is an okay strategy, but at the same time, they're not gambling and taking ground, so it can work against you if you're unable to defend properly if the big play comes. I'd much rather be in Nunya's position, personally.
Yeah, I'd be much rather having a Uber advantage holding onto Choke because they know that they're going to have to, you know, almost solo this Uber onto Husky or onto Ali to, you know, get anything done. And, you know, there's a lot of space to cut in that Choke area if you're Ubering it on their heavy. And actually, they're playing extremely passive right now. Ali and Husky are both not pressurizing Choke whatsoever.
Waiting for the flank to spawn, probably.
Yeah, and Aferix is holding down this choke. He's going to get and try and ring out those headshots as they push in. And T-Time, if you look carefully where T-Time's holding, just carefully positioning himself, going to hold so close that, you know, as soon as that Uber comes out, actually, no, they're going to go towards Big Door. And this is going to be a quick change-up. Colossus is going to be able to call this, though, and he's currently behind them. And at the moment, you know, this is looking really good. The conch comes out, and the counter Uber is much better. It's going to be soloed, but actually Bacon gets picked off there, and Colotto also gets picked
Husky.
Off. So Husky is still alive underneath, and he's going to get off the medic as well. Husky really well played there, just managing to hold onto that ramp. And you know, Raggers are giving themselves a chance.
Yeah, huge error by Joe. They didn't pick off. They didn't use their better Uber to pick off combo players. They went for the medic frag. Two people committed for him. They got cleaned up. They've just given Ragnarok a chance to push last. I mean, they could have won that fight decisively if they just focused getting the combo players down and the second phase of play they focused on the frags. And oh, Layla's been picked as well by York, and I've got an Uber advantage with Lazy Bear. Yeah, this is a great chance. How's your nerve, Samsky?
Oh, 2 minutes and 40 seconds remaining. I'm actually nervous. I wanted Nunya to be able to close this out. You know, I don't want these guys to be playing. You know,
wow,
in high.
Rude.
I want them to. I want these new upcoming players to, you know, knock out those old guys. So at the moment, they're probably just going to be waiting for that Uber. Lazy Bear knows that he has around a 40% advantage, probably by the spawn of Layla. Kazul and Onkaya actually both go down, so that's going to delay the push even more. And actually, Layla's building this rather efficiently. She's already closed the gap. Actually, she's on Quick Fix, so that's probably why. So they're going to be defending with Quick Fix, not always the best. But if they can force this Uber relatively early, then and keep Layla alive, then this could actually work out in the post-Uber.
Oh, no.
And Lazy drops Husky in the Uber. That's going to be massive. Kali's actually going to come down, and there is a level 3 sentry to deal with. But the pyro's on the point, and no one's capping the point! Oh my god, they managed to cap the point so close there, and they need to stand on this point with the quick fix. They can't be blown off the point with the quick fix, so, you know, they can just stand on the point, they can't get air blasted. So that's one of the perks of the quick fix. So at the moment, you know, Lazy Bear did survive, but Layla's going to get this quick fix before him now.
I want to see Lazy go crits.
I don't think he has time, it's 1.5 minutes left.
No, they have time for one crits, but he went medigun, so it doesn't matter anyway. Yeah, that level 3 and... denying them entry, and they didn't drop in Husky, didn't get much damage on the combo. I mean, I like the idea of getting people water, force people down to the cap, but you've got to have some presence after Uber to make that work, and their combo had no presence at all.
Yeah, sorry, I didn't realise that that Lazy Bear had died there, so I thought he'd stayed on the Uber because he had survived, so I didn't realise that he had the opportunity
He might have survived.
Yeah,
sorry.
I thought he survived, yeah. So that's why I said that he doesn't have time to go back to spawn and then, you know, and then take it. Anyway, the Uber is going to come out, and Layla's going to hold on to this quick fix until need be, and Husky's actually going to go underneath the point, and they on the smart thing. They pop the quick fix on the point, they know they can't get blown off, and they're just going to keep everyone healed up. Husky's going to go down. That means that underneath is completely empty. The medic, Lazy Bear, is so weak. Jackie Legs with a six kill streak. And, you know, they didn't kill Layla. They didn't focus the frags. And that is going to be game, set, and match. I'm calling it now. There's no way that in 20 seconds they're going to get 9 players down. And congratulations to Nuno. You will be replacing Chess Club in this season in Prem.
Only the biggest throw in TF2 history, that is, if they somehow let Kazul cap last, could they lose this? No, he gets spotted by Tea Time. So, yep, it is GG. It is GG indeed. Your first team in Prem from these Premiership playoffs will be Nuno. That is Joe Layla, but, you know. Got to give commiserations to Ragnarok, aka the ex-Chess Club team. I don't know whether or not they'll want to continue playing in high next season. We'll have to see. But you know, they lost the final. They had a few of their players leave. They had a bad preseason, so their roster's folded. They've come into playoffs with a new roster, tried to make it work. Unfortunately, they ran into a very good side that's well prepared in Nuno, and they will be blessing us with their presence in the ETFTR next season. And you know what? They look like a decent team.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to seeing what they can get done, because the cohesion that they had together as a team for the most part was really, really solid. So now I'm looking forward to seeing them in action in Prem when they've had, you know, a couple more weeks together. They can sort out those little flaws. But on Payload especially, they look really solid.
Yeah, we might have some players coming in for an interview. I know Joe is probably coming in. People want Condog interview. He is welcome to come as well. So let's see if anyone's going to be joining us for an interview. Samsky, but great performance from Nuno. I was a little worried for them on Gully Wash. They didn't seem like the complete package. A couple of their decisions were a little bit odd, but they won Upward fairly convincingly. They looked like a better team, and some of their players can play TF2. You know, sometimes you get these player teams that have been together for a while, and they don't perform, or they have a couple of individuals who aren't good enough. But in Nunez's case, people like Jackie Legs, Colotso, Aetherix, and even Corndog on the level 3 can play. But we're joined by Joe NUFC and Scissors.
Let's start with Scissors. Commiseration, Scissors. Do you think that you just didn't really have enough time as a team to get used to each other's playstyles to be able to put on a good enough performance against this solid team?
Well, considering the only time we ever played was today, then yeah.
Yeah. Anything else? Like, are you going to play in high next season? Are you going to stick together?
Yeah, we're going to play in high. Like, the thing is, it's more fun to win high than it is to be low, mid, and prem anyways. We're just going to, like, scrim against the teams and just win high and then win prem next season.
So you don't think that there are any other teams, you know, obviously there are two other matches for Prem playoffs. You don't think any of those other teams have a chance against you?
To get us? Oh, in high?
In high, yes.
Oh, no. Like, we got the hard team in the playoffs, unfortunately, and we couldn't win today. But I don't know all the high teams, but if those are the other high teams that wanted to go Prem, then I think, like, this team has some really good players. Once we get to play a bit more together, we should be a good team.
Other people are wondering in chat, /Hildroth is pointing at me to ask. They want to know about what happened exactly with Chess Club. Why do people leave? Like, what happened there? Why has this suddenly happened that you've had to remake a team in the last dying moments before sign-ups close?
Well, it's been a problem for a long time now, like, that we have... Nobody really cared anymore, you know, like, we had a really, in my opinion, really poor attitude towards it. Like, people would often not show up. Like, I had to ask people way too many times to fill out, like, when they were available and stuff like that. And we just lost the drive completely. And it happened, like, even during the last season. And it just, like, after... I think there was a reason why Quintosh quit, and he was, like, a big... You know, what do you call it? Inspirational factor. Like, he was sort of keen and stuff. So losing him it was just really... The attitude was just really poor. And I just, like, I could see... Even though we did all right in scrims and stuff, I could see that this wasn't going to work long term this season. So I'd rather just make a team with people who, you know, actually want to play and have fun and stuff.
It's champion syndrome. We had it in season 7. when we'd won season 6, so I guess I can understand where Scissors is coming from. I mean, Quintosh mentioned the same thing actually after the season ended in the award show. So my only question left for Scissors is, this team, how keen are you going to be to win? Are you going to be practicing a lot? These new players coming in, are they going to be you going to be coaching them?
Well, the thing is, right now people said they were going to be keen, but you never know what happens like along the way. And we didn't expect to lose today, honestly. So, like, I don't know how many want to play high, but I got the feeling that most people want to just, you know, keep playing. So, but I think it's really too early to tell. I expected us, like, I read the news post just, like, really briefly, and I thought that we had until Friday to sign up, and then we would play the playoffs, but apparently not. So I literally had to get everyone on, like, on the roster last night, and we just, like, played today for the first time.
Yeah.
So, like, I really can't make predictions about that sort of stuff already.
To be fair, you did look like you needed a bit more time. Maybe ETF2L should factor that in a little bit next season, or maybe give teams two chances to qualify, because at the same time, you could have played one of the other teams in the playoff and beaten them, like, but you ran into a Ninja side who are actually quite good. That's my view on it.
Yeah, I was kind of disappointed that we only had, like, that we didn't do, you know, what do you call it? Where you, yeah, like you said, where you, we can play another of the teams if they lose. But I think
that was the case because there were so many teams that wanted to get into Prem, and there was six teams with three spots. So to be honest, the only best way is that the admins gave like mini rankings to people, like predictions that who were going to win. And I'm guessing that what from my idea is that you two were the closest two teams together. I.e., like they couldn't decide between the two of you. That's why you guys played against each other.
How are you going to decide like which team's better than which? That's the point of playoff, surely. But, you know, I could rant about that. But, you know, I want to be bringing Joe NUFC in and congratulating on him back in the big time. Joe, my boy, how was that game for you guys?
Yeah, it was good. Pretty easy.
Pretty easy? That's a bit, it's a bit cocky, that is. I thought they ran you quite hard on Gully.
We did stupid mistakes, like always, with my teams, but whatever. 2-0, happy with it.
Joe gives that kind of, you know, that motivation throughout the whole entire thing. Like, it's hard to really feel like you're going to lose when Joe's just saying easy after every round, you know?
Do you think the lack of practice had anything to do with it? Because Scissors thinks it's a big impact on the game, or were you going to be confident whether or not they had been scrimming for 6 weeks?
No, we were fine. We were fine with it. Knew my team was going to win no matter what, even if it went to three maps. I thought they were going to win Gullywash 100%, but oh well. Yeah. It was a struggle on Gullywash, but we got there in the end. We slowed it down, didn't do stupid stuff, let Corndog have a level 3 sentry for half the game, and it worked. So.
Yeah, I did notice the level 3. We kind of noticed that on the cast about how effective it was. It's not something you usually see, a level 3 sentry being effective.
I think he only ran it because he had high ping, so...
You reckon we're not going to see that next season, then?
Maybe, we'll see. We'll see what the big Corndog does.
Corndog is the wild card we're bringing into this season. Who knows what he's going to unleash upon Prem now?
Could be a best NG.
Well, with players like Doom, I don't know, I don't think so.
True.
But, I do have one question for Carlotto. We were talking about this pre-cast, me and Samski, about your progression. Like, I remember a couple of years ago when First Nations Cup came along and you were on the team as a backup to Grenger, and it was very close between you and Grenger picking you, and then you played for this kill switch and your team had that poor season and you kind of faded away. But are you back now? Are you ready to fulfill your potential? Because you put in a good performance today.
Absolutely. I mean, I took a good break and I sort of chilled in high last season. It's been hard trying to find a team that I've completely gelled with. And the last team that I really felt a huge connection with was definitely with Tipping Intensifiers way back in UGC. I can't remember the season, but with Joe... I just worked with him better than any other demo. So when I was approached by Corndog before this season, I didn't originally have plans to play. Corndog approached me, asked me would I be able to try out this team with Joe? And I was definitely a bit suspicious because Joe did name drop what's his name? The other spy that
Chupa.
He's played with, Chupa, that's it, as his favourite spy to work with. And I was offended, you know, we've had that tipping experience in the past. But I was eager to try it out, and it was just really good from the get-go. I've been practicing really hard, you know, and yeah, things have been going well for me so far. And I'm happy to play with Joe again. This team definitely feels as one of the strongest that I've been on so far. So yeah, I feel like I've progress more as a player, and yeah, I'm excited to be duking it out with Toast and Grenger and the likes again.
Fair play. I do finally have one actual last question for Joe Boy. Yes. What do you think your team can do next season? That's what I really want to know.
Top three, I think that. Nothing else? Yeah, I think top three, maybe two. Second place, if you want. First place, whatever you want to dream about.
Okay, so no.
If we play like this every match, then sure.
Well, maybe. I mean, Upward was dominating, but the gully was very tight. So potentially,
we've had very little practice on maps like that.
I wanted to ban CP maps, like the two CP maps, but Scissors picked Gullywash for some strange reason.
Because his team's good at it, maybe?
Because I saw you ban Process, so I figured you're probably better. Like I said, we haven't played any games, so I wouldn't know what maps we're good at. So I just figured since you banned a 5 CP map, you're probably not very good at that.
No, I just banned them because you have... Most teams have, I'd say, more experience than us on CP maps.
Come on, Joe, you can give Scissors some credit.
I don't know, I was just thinking, most of the time, most people have like a lot of Sixers players when they play Highlander now, so...
You can give Scissors some credit there, you know, that's Wily experience Scissors, the leader.
Anyway.
But I like it, positive for the season. So we could wrap this up. So there's a few things to do before we get to shout-outs. First of all, you got to come and join us back on that Blackout TV for the rest of the playoffs. I think tomorrow there's the Premtech versus Budget Toucans game. That's going to be on tomorrow. Hopefully we can get a cast up for Blackout then. And I think also Fair Enough game is scheduled tomorrow. They're called Sandwiches Team with my name on it. For the record, I just want to say it was Samsky that said that, not me. But I guess I get all the headlines anyway. So those casts are going to be coming up tomorrow on Blackout, and also on Saturday. The time is not confirmed, but we're going to have a pre-season show with the usual suspects. Not Mookie. Go away, Mookie. So we're going to be discussing the upcoming season. All the Prem teams should be confirmed by then. And we're also going to be discussing Deutschland as well, which has been announced in the last few weeks. So big hype for that. And my final plug is going to be to the spire.tv. I'll post it again in the chat for everybody, but new news website coming up, going to be a lot of news about Highlander on that website as well, so yeah, check that out, definitely. Thanks to CJ for writing a pre-season playoff prediction. Check that article out on the spire.tv. So Samsky, do you want to do some shout-outs?
Yeah, sure. Carlso, any shout-outs?
I'd like to shout out Bacon, my main man. Yeah, he played a fantastic game there, kept us all in check. Corn Dog, because it's Corn Dog, and Fungi for heading up Dishland, and probably being one of the only few players that I've played with since Div 6. So, yeah, that's it for me.
Fungi, what about Stinson? He was the man behind Dishland.
Yeah, but me and Fungi have a connection, man. He jumps in and misses everything, but it's great. I love it.
Jonoff, any shout outs?
Yeah, shout out my team. Shout out for everyone who betted on us, that 15%, get you that money, you know what I mean. And that's everything. Oh, shout out to Corndog, best NG this season, watch out. That's it.
Miss Diog, do you have any shout outs?
Well, shout out to Scissors for actually picking me up and playing with you guys, even though it was such a short hand, because we really didn't play much. But shout out to my team, and shout out to Nanya for being a good team. You should stick together.
Scissors.
Shout out to Stinson. And shout out to Blackout John. And Evil, as always.
Hildreth, finally.
I've got a shout out to the ETF2 admins for the putting together the map test cup, and also for not banning the Razorback, which I thought that they are banning because I was listening to Mookie trolling. So I apologise for that again, boys. So good play by them. Shout out to Stinson as well for the organising Deutschland, and CJ for contributing to Despire.tv. Lots of people contributing, especially this man, who's nobody's mentioned, John, as well. So I want to show him some love. And yeah.
What the fuck, I didn't mention him.
You did mention Blackout, I suppose. By association, it works.
I said Blackout John.
Okay, so Scissors knows who to appreciate.
Yeah.
That's just why I
know,
like,
who's
Scissors
keeping the stuff alive.
Shout out to TF2 Pickup, to Hildreth, to John, and to Popcorp and Doom, because otherwise they'll shout at me for not giving them shout outs. This has been Sasuke and Hildreth on Blackout TV. It was the first Premiership playoffs which Nunya took, so Nunya are going to be the first team we see in Premiership with joining the others. See you tomorrow for the rest of the casts.